Howdy. In this video, I'd be replacing the battery on a Samsung Galaxy. It's an old phone, but it's still working good, and I love the camera. That's what I use before I have the other Samsung to make my videos. So I'd be replacing the battery. The battery is dead. The back came out. I was watching the security cameras of it, and it got very hot, and the glue came apart. But to replace your battery, first you have to remove your SIM card. I dropped it. Then you have to remove the back. Now the back is held on by a glue. You would have to take a hair dryer or a blower and heat all around it to the touch. Don't heat it too much because you might damage the board or the blow up the battery, but just heat all around it because it has glue around this area here. And you take a prying tool. When you buy the battery, it usually come with the prying tool. That's what came with the battery. The battery, a set of tools, and adhesive. And you would put the prying tool between the cover and the thing. You need to use the suction cup. You put the suction cup on the cover. Better you start from the bottom. You put a suction cup on the cover, and you would pull the suction cup up. It would give you a little space here where you would get the prying tool, and you would work it down. But you have to be very careful because this is glass and it has black paint. Usually when you do it, the black paint will come out, or portion of it would come out. So you'd have to be very, very careful that you don't break your glass. When you get a little opening, you would use these picks to work your way through. With the battery, that's the tools that came with the battery, to work your way through all around until you get the cover off. Then you would take out these screws, get the right Phillips. Okay. I've got the tool. It's a Phillips screwdriver. I don't know the size. Then you will go around. Remove the screws. when you get all the screws removed, do a check to make sure all you remove all the screws. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 screws. This is a wireless pad. That's for the wireless. Then what you would do is you would push on the battery down here, or you could lift up the wireless pad. Push, put your fingernail underneath when it open, and use your prying tool. This is it. My battery was already swollen. Then you disconnect your battery by just clipping it. Now what holds the battery down is just some glue. You would take your prying tool, put it underneath the battery. Do not press too hard or put too much force to break your screen. Just work your way through. I've got some cards. And this is it. It still has some and then you would place your new battery on. You would match, make sure everything is okay, then you would place the battery in. Now, sometimes if it's difficult to get a battery out, you would have to take out the board by disconnecting these antenna wires. But for me, it wasn't that difficult. Then you'll take out that sticker because it has the information on it of the phone. And you would place it on this one. I've noticed the switch came out. Then you'd put the screen back in the case. When you're placing the screen, start from the bottom. So your charging port and the headphone jack would enter. And you would place your screws back. It seems like it don't have any charge. Now I won't bore you in putting the screws on the back plate back. Make sure the battery is connected properly. It is. This is how you change the battery on your Samsung S6. You put all your screws back. You take the adhesive. You place the adhesive on and you put your back cover on. This is it for this video. If you find it was informative, please like, comment, subscribe, click on the bell icon so you'll be notified of further videos. Now I've revived my Samsung Galaxy S6. It's an old phone. It works good. I love it. Goodbye and thank you.